Hi, my name is Chris Pacioni. I'm Director and CEO of Luma Institute. Real pleased here to be here today. We're doing a human-centered design workshop around looking at the issue of how we can get folks in Western Michigan to consider alternate forms of transport, things to, you know, to improve the quality of life and reduce costs and certainly the environment. And we're collaborating here today with the Keller Futures Center and Amway's Business Innovations Group.
My name is Seth Starner. I work for Amway's Business Innovations. And the whole point of this three-day workshop is to teach community members, educators, and business people about human-centered design. And so we've chosen the question of transportation in West Michigan and how we can improve how transportation, both public and private and otherwise, all works together to create a better environment in West Michigan.
Hi, I'm Bill Fluharty. I'm with the Keller Futures Center, and I'm here at Grid 70. So we're in day one of a three-day workshop using the human-centered design process, and today was about context building. It was about learning to be empathetic to the end user, understanding that when we design things, we're designing for somebody else, not for ourselves specifically. And we turned some exercises in empathy into insights that are then going to be fuel for solutions finding in the next couple of days.
We kicked off the morning with actually doing things. This whole session is about learning how to do human-centered design, but to do human-centered design is really about doing it and not just hearing about it. So we started off with a really simple exercise. And it was about really to show people how quickly they can come up with ideas, collaborate on an idea, and then give an example or a prototype or a concept of an idea.
So just as an example of what we did today, we identified key stakeholders in the transportation system in West Michigan. And you can see behind me an example of one of six teams' efforts to define who the key stakeholders are. And what their issues are, what are the things they care about, what are their perspectives on the greater transportation system in West Michigan. They try to imagine everybody involved, from policymakers to people who use the transportation system, professional drivers as well as recreational drivers or normal people, and then all the systems that support a transportation system. When we finished this stakeholder map and kind of got a sense for what people in these different categories thought about the system, we went out and actually talked to key stakeholders in the system.
What we had people do is take all their insights and turn them either what we call a rose, a bud, or a thorn. A rose is something positive they heard, something somebody said that was positive about their commute or why they ride their bike or etc. A bud is something of potential, right? Potential meaning yeah, it's like this now, but if we did a little bit more of that, it might be a good thing. And of course, a thorn is something that has, it's something that has to be pruned, right? It's something that is a problem. What we're looking for is the patterns. And what we see here is the emergence of these different patterns. There's a lot of issues around education awareness. It turned out, as we can see here, a lot of thorns and opportunities around people don't even know what options they have. Today was about what we call empathy to insight, really immersing us into the problem and talking to people with a sense of humility about the problem statement. Tomorrow we're going to be doing a variety of ideation techniques to aid the mind in thinking and help people think divergently. But then ideation is not just about thinking divergently, coming up with ideas, but how do you promote the better ideas? So convergent thinking, how do we begin to whittle down the ideas that we think have legs that we would promote and actually bring to life? And so it's that divergent and convergent thinking we're going to be doing tomorrow through various techniques.